Hello and welcome back to the channel. My name is Lian Duan and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. In this video, I'd like to share 4 best practices for using Gradle with GitLab. These best practices are based on my experience working with over 100 pipelines to build around 2 million lines of code. The first best practice is using a Gradle wiper in your pipeline file. Gradle and Gradle wiper are both tools for running Gradle builds, but Gradle wiper has an advantage. Gradle wiper is a script that comes with Gradle project, ensuring that you're using the correct version of Gradle for that project, regardless of the version of the Gradle installed on your GitLab runner or doc image in the job. That's generally recommended to use Gradle wiper instead of Gradle command to ensure compatibility and avoid potential issues. The second best practice is to separate build and test stages in your GitLab CI/CD pipeline. Test means unit test. By creating separate jobs for building and testing, you can quickly identify which job has an issue, the build or the unit test, without having to check the job log file. The next best practice is to avoid caching in your GitLab pipeline. Well, cache can speed up builds. It can also cause issues if the cache artifacts are out of date. The build parameter clean plus no build cache function equal to no cache. You can choose one of them. Both options will disable cache for task inputs and outputs and disable the build cache during the build process. This means Gradle will regenerate all build outputs from scratch, even there were previous generated in the previous build. Finally, this important tool locks the exact version of your third-party or first-party dependencies. When a project uses Gradle to manage its dependencies, it typically specifies a set of dependencies in the build.gradle file. However, if the project is built on different machines or different times, it is possible that the dependencies may be updated or changed, which could potentially break the build. To prevent that, you can use build.gradle.log file to log the specified version of each dependencies that project needs. Run Gradle wiper dependencies plus --write-logs to create a build.gradle.log file. If you have to upgrade the dependencies, delete the build.gradle.log file and add a parameter refresh dependencies to generate new dependencies and create a log file again. If you want to see the best practices in action, check out GitLab project Common Lab with main branch, which includes all the details. The Common Lab project uses Gradle 7.5.1. I hope you found those best practices informative and helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching.